I'm Matthew Taylor, Flow Science's IT administrator. In this brief tutorial, I'd like to share troubleshooting tips for licensing problems with Flow-3D, Flow-3D Cast, and Flow-3D MP. The normal license configuration can be found in the documentation for your product, which is installed in the help directory by default. Across all of our products, Flow Science uses FlexERA's FlexLM system for software license management. This system consists of several components. The main component is the license server. This is a general-purpose executable named LMGRD, which can be run on the local machine where Flow-3D is installed or on a different machine on the network. There is another executable named F3D-TKNUX that handles the Flow-3D license file features. It is known as the vendor daemon. The vendor daemon determines which features will be made available by reading a license file, which is a text file with special encryption codes. Typically, the license server machine is equipped with a USB dongle that allows the decryption of the license file. The decryption can also be done based on the MAC address. The Flow-3D graphical user interface and CFD solver executables request features from the license server. This is achieved using an environment variable. The variable is handled slightly differently on the Windows and Linux platforms. It is named F3DTKNUX_license_file and will be discussed in detail in the troubleshooting portion of this presentation. The final component in the licensing system is communication. Whether the server is on the local machine or running on a remote system, the client and server must be able to communicate with one another in order to use Flow-3D. Some jargon is used in this tutorial, which can cause confusion. Here are some common terms. The dongle is the physical device that is used to control which software features are available. It plugs into a USB port on the machine acting as a license server. The dongle is provided by Flow Science. The FlexiD is the number used when the license is locked to a USB dongle. It is printed on the side of the dongle and is also used in the license file. The HostID is the number used when the license is locked to a network node. It is the MAC address of the machine, which will run the license server. The license daemon is the LMGRD executable, which was created by FlexERA. The vendor daemon is the F3D-TKNUX executable. That is created by Flow Science. The client is the machine which will be requesting licenses. This can be the same machine on which the license server software is used, or a different machine connected to the same network as the license server. This may also refer to the Flow-3D graphical user interface, or CFD solver. The server is the machine which runs the license server software, and may also refer to the LMGRD and F3D-TKNUX executables. First, we should ensure that the dongle is working properly. The red light should be lit. If it is not lit, there is a driver or communication problem. Often, moving the dongle to another USB port will resolve the issue. It is recommended to connect the dongle to a USB 2 port rather than a USB 3 port. USB 3 ports are identified by the blue plastic on the connector. If the dongle still fails to light, reinstalling the driver may be the solution. The driver can be found in one of several places. On the Windows operating system, when the installation executable has been run, a preinstall directory is created in the licenses subdirectory within the installation directory. In this preinstall directory, an executable named hinstall.exe will reinstall the driver. On the Flow-3D cast CD, this executable can be found in the hinstall directory. A reboot may be necessary before the driver recognizes the USB dongle. When the communication is established, the dongle should light up. On the Linux operating system, the Sentinel hasp driver is found in the tarred and gzipped installation file. It is a pair of RPM files starting with aksusbd. These files can be installed by navigating to the directory where the file has been untarred and issuing the command rpm-i aksusb star. A reboot should not be necessary. If you have tried these troubleshooting steps and the dongle is still not lit, please contact support@flow3d.com or call Flow Science at area code 505-982-0088. The Flow Science License Administrator provides the license file. The license file should be placed in the licenses subdirectory of the Flow3D installation, and by default, these locations are as follows. For Flow3D, version 10.1. For Flow3D Cast, version 3.5. And for Flow3D MP. The license file can be opened using a text editor to ensure it is correct for the machine. The only line which can be edited without causing a failure is the first line of the file, which begins with the word server. The first entry is the hostname or IP address. It must match the machine's hostname or IP address unless a dongle is used. If a dongle is used, the default, this_host, is sufficient. The hostname can be found by right-clicking computer and choosing properties on Windows. On Linux, issue the command hostname in a terminal. The next item is the HostID or FlexiD. This should match the dongle ID or the MAC address of the computer. The dongle ID is printed on the side of the dongle. The IP and MAC addresses can be determined using the command prompt found in the Windows Start menu by issuing the command ipconfig /all. On Linux, in a terminal window, use the command ifconfig -a. The last configurable option on the server line is the port number. By default, this is not included in the file, and the license server uses port 27000. If the machine is running other software that uses the FlexLM licensing system, such as AutoCAD, the default port may be in use. If this occurs, a different port can be specified at the end of the server line in this license file. This is done by adding a port number at the end of the line. It is common to use a high port number in the 20,000 range to avoid other conflicts. If port 27,000 is in use, we tend toward port 27,010. When changing the port, it is also important to ensure that the firewall allows traffic on the new port. The installer automatically allows the LMGRD executable through the Windows firewall through whatever port you choose. On Linux, please check the configuration for iptables or whatever firewall software is being used. Finally, some users have third-party firewall tools. To allow traffic, please refer to the security software documentation to open the relevant ports. After verifying that the dongle is working and the license file is configured to the environment, the license server can be run and checked on the local machine. To start the license server and write a log file, please navigate to the licenses directory in your installation using either the Windows command prompt or a Linux terminal. Here is the command for Windows, and here is the command for Linux. Issue this command to start the license server and write a log file. The -c flag indicates the license file name, and the -l flag indicates the log file name. These can be changed to your preference. We like to test the server using the supplied command line utility from FlexERA. This command will display status information about the running license server. Again, this is common between Windows and Linux operating systems. A good way to check for issues is to open the log file in a text editor. Dongle communication issues and hostname mismatches will be described here fairly clearly. Other issues typically give an error code, which can be given to our support team for further troubleshooting. If lmutil and the log file do not show errors and indicate that the server is running, communication from the client to the server may be the issue. This can occur even if the client and server are on the same machine. The environment variables are set in different ways between Windows and Linux. On Windows, the installer creates a batch file in the local subdirectory of the FLOW-3D installation directory. The batch file is named flow3d.bat. It can be edited by navigating there or simply by right-clicking the desktop icon. Giving the variable a value is done using the set command. On Linux, the installer creates a shell script in the local subdirectory of the FLOW-3D installation directory. It is named flow3dvars.sh and can be edited using a text editor. Giving a variable a value is done using the export command. In either case, the licensing variable is named f3dtkinux_license_file. The port is the default. A server name or IP address preceded by the at symbol is used. Here's an example for Windows. And here is an example for Linux. When using a different port, the port must be specified before the at symbol. This will be the same port that you used in your license file. Here's an example for Windows. And here is an example for Linux. The final link in the chain is communication. The license server runs on a given port, and if this port is blocked at any point between the client and the server, the license checkout cannot occur. The most common failure is at the firewall on the server machine. Port 27000, or the port you specified in the license file, must be open. Again, the default should allow communication. With additional security software, the easiest troubleshooting step is to temporarily disable its firewall capability and then test whether a license can be checked out. If so, please refer to the security software's documentation on how to allow communication on the preferred port. Another common problem is the firewall on the client machine. The installer will automatically open the necessary port, but additional security software may override this. Again, temporarily disabling the firewall will quickly demonstrate whether this is causing problems. Finally, especially within secure environments, network routers and switches can block the necessary ports. In such an environment, it may be necessary to contact the IT department and determine if this is the case. They will be able to test whether the server is responding at the appropriate port across the network. We have also seen cases where the port is only blocked when connecting over a VPN. Again, the local IT department would address such a situation. We hope this video has been useful and informative, and solved the problem. For questions or unresolved issues, please contact Flow Science's support department at support@flow3d.com or area code 505-982-0088, and we will be happy to assist. Thanks for watching.